The Duchess of Cambridge was the picture of elegance as she arrived for a glittering gala dinner in London on Wednesday night. Kate, 37, donned a bespoke Gucci gown as she joined female leaders for the annual 100 Women in Finance event at the Victoria and Albert Museum. The delicate floor-length dress featured layers of pleated tulle and a soft array of pinks and was the perfect choice for an engagement on the eve of Valentine's Day. Bringing even more glamour to her look, the royal accessorized with a dazzling pair of £568 Oscar de Laurentiis pumps and a beautiful pair of earrings by Kiki McDonough, which she wore to her sister Pippa Middleton's wedding. Following a lavish dinner, the Duchess gave a heartfelt speech where she said the vision of the event and the Women in Finance initiative was inspiring. After the event, Kate was pictured leaving with a sweet bouquet of flowers and even gave a royal wave to crowds and press that had gathered outside. After being introduced by Ed Vanker, co-founder and principal of the Reach Academy in Feltham, she said, "I think you know just how passionate I am about the work that you do, and what you have said here tonight really brings to life the vital role that schools and teachers play in supporting our youngest children. Your vision is hugely inspiring and testament to what school, teachers, parents and communities can achieve when they all work together." She added that she had often been asked why she had decided to focus her work on the early years and said that many adult problems can be traced back to the first years of life. "I have often been asked why I have decided to focus my work on the early years. Having been lucky enough to meet some of our country's amazing charities and organizations, tackling some of our hardest social challenges, I became acutely aware just how important the earliest years of our lives really are. The root cause of some of our most challenging experiences in adulthood, such as poor mental and physical health, addiction, homelessness, crime and family breakdown, can so often be traced back to the very earliest years of someone's life and often over generations. We therefore need to look at the prevention of some of these issues, before they take hold and become a problem. The evidence is clear that from birth, the first few years of a child's life are more pivotal for social, physical and emotional development and for future health and happiness than any other single moment in a lifetime." Stunning in a Gucci dress, she added that she believed that the positive development of babies and children is directly linked to the well-being of those who care for children, parents, carers and teachers. "In my early years work, I am looking at how best we can support parents and families. However, we must remember that teachers, school leaders and school staff also play a vital role in shaping who our children become and how they develop. It is therefore critical that we support them so that they can provide the best level of care for all children in their schools and communities. The Mentally Healthy Schools program is the first of its kind and aims to help all children, all teachers and all primary schools across the UK. The dinner will benefit the Royal Foundation's Heads Together program, Mentally Healthy Schools." Kate was the guest of honor at the fundraiser in support of the Royal Foundation program, which aims to help people of all ages start conversations about their mental health and is a key focus of her public work. During her speech, she added, "Providing the latest information and advice on some of the most difficult topics, it will encourage schools and teachers to highlight the importance of mental health and to prioritize the emotional development of our children. We have also heard loud and clear from teachers and parents that access to this sort of support is important to them too. I believe passionately in working together. We all need to start understanding the importance of childhood development, and tackling this from home and from school, through parents and teachers, if we are to help raise the next happy and healthy generation of adults." Kate went on to thank the Women in Finance initiative and said the group had been unwavering in its support. "Over the past decade, you have been unwavering in your support of our patronages and your efforts have made a huge difference to so many of our charities. So I just wanted to say thank you for this wonderful evening and for all of your support over the years. I can't tell you what a difference it makes. Thank you." Before the event, the Duchess was greeted by former Labour MP Tristram Hunt, director of the V&A, of which she is patron, and Colonel Jane Davis, Vice Lord Lieutenant of Greater London. She then joined 100WF CEO Amanda Pulliner and Lauren Malafronti, chair of its Global Association Board, telling them, "This time last year I was still pregnant. The Duchess later joined 300 guests in the opulent surroundings of the museum's Raphael Gallery, taking her seat at the top table along with the Royal Foundation's CEO Lorraine Hegesi and Chairman Sir Keith Mills. She was welcomed by Lauren Malaford and listened as Ed Vanker, co-founder and principal of the Reach Academy in Feltham, told guests about the impact mental health charities are having in schools. Ed has worked with the Duchess as part of the steering group of experts she commissioned to examine mental health provision and early intervention last year and has helped to develop mentally healthy schools. Speaking ahead of the dinner, he said, "The focus that the Duchess has had on this and on the mental health agenda has really helped schools, parents and young people to destigmatize it and talk about it. She visited my school a year ago and spent 3 or 4 hours in the school, hearing about the challenges young people face. She's obviously really personally interested in it, she builds relationships really easily and she had a huge impact in a short time when she came to see us." Kate, who along with her husband William and brother-in-law Harry is patron of 100 Women in Finance's philanthropic initiatives, has attended 3 previous galas held by the organization in aid of charities associated with the young royals. 100 Women in Finance, previously known as 100 Women in Hedge Funds, is a leading nonprofit organization for professionals in the alternative investments industry. Each year, 100WF's board of directors selects a beneficiary for its philanthropic initiatives, which cover women's and family health, mentoring and education programs. Mentally Healthy Schools is a free, expert-backed online resource, which provides advice, information and practical tools, such as lesson and assembly plans, to help primary school teachers, leaders and staff support children's well-being. The project, a legacy of the Heads Together campaign, was developed by the youth-focused charity partners of Heads Together, the Anna Freud National Center for Children and Families, Place to Be in Young Minds. It was launched by the Duchess of Cambridge in January 2018 during a visit to Row Green Junior School in Brent, North London. The conference at Mercer's Hall today brought together delegates from across the mental health and education sectors to explore and discuss the benefits of collaborative working and what more can be done to tackle mental health issues in schools. Following her introduction from Kate Silverton, the Duchess of Cambridge delivered a speech thanking those who were there in helping to improve mental health in schools. Addressing the crowd, she said, "It's really so exciting to hear everyone here speaking with your wealth of experience about the importance of mental health and particularly the emotional development of our children and teachers. What we have all been discussing here today really brings to light the vital role teachers are playing in supporting our youngest children's mental health. Thank you all for your dedication to this important cause, whether you work in schools, universities, charities or elsewhere."